فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
باب المنادى. المنادى خمسة أنواع: النكرة في العلم، والنكرة في المقصود، والنكرة غير المقصود، والمضاف، والمشبه بالمضاف.
The author now goes into المنادى. And it, what it means is that مطلق المطلوب إقباله is when you basically call out somebody to make, want them to do something particularly. It's calling somebody out. Okay? And it is categorized into five types as the author did right now here. The first one is المفرد العلم. مفرد العلم. Whether it's a مذكر or a مؤنث. Okay? So يا محمود يا محمدان يا مسلمون يا عائشتان ويا فاطمة ويا هندات ويا رجال. All of those are مفرد. مفرد here is the opposite of جملة. The second one he mentions is النكرة المقصودة. النكرة المقصودة basically means هي التي قصد بها معين. It is that which has been intended. It's actually been intended specifically. It's like يا ظالم, your oppressor. And there's another one which is, so you're actually intending an oppressor that's in front of you, right? The third one is النكرة غير مقصودة. The نكرة is not intended. وهي لم يقصد بها معين. A specific person is not intended. And this is where you would say يا غافلا تنبه, you heedless one. Wake up. You're not really intending anybody, but you're calling for anyone who falls under that. Under that. The fourth one is al-mudafu ila ghayrihi. Al-mudafu ila ghayrihi. It is attributing something to other than it. For example, saying ya talib al-ilm ijtahid. Ya talib al-ilm, a student of knowledge, ijtahid. The fifth one is al-shabihu bil-mudaf. It looks like a mudaf. It resembles it. And it's, for example, when you say يَا فَاهِمًا دَرْسًا, for example. For example, you say يَا لَطِيفًا بِالْعِبَادِ. نعم.
فأما المفرد العلم والنكرة المقصود فيبنياني على الضم من غير تنوين.
So المفرد العلم النكرة المقصودة, both of them are البناء على ما يرفعان به. They are what? مبني على الضم without any تنوين. And the next three remaining, which is النكرة غير مقصودة and المضاف إلى غيره and الشبيه بالمضاف, all of those are منصوب بالفتحة.
نعم. يا زيد ويا رجل, والثلاثة الباقية منصوبة لا غير.
The other three, which is he's talking about نكرة غير مقصودة, المضاف إلى غيره, الشبيه بالمضاف, all of those are منصوب بالفتحة. نعم.
باب المفعول من أجله, وهو الاسم المنصوب الذي يذكر بيانا لسبب وقوع الفعل, نحو قولك قام زيد إجلالا لعمر وقصدتك ابتغاء معروفك.
The author now goes into al-maf'ulu min ajlihi. According to the grammarian, al-maf'ulu min ajlihi is a ism, which is either sarih, it can be no problem, that noun can be sarih, or it can even be a mu'awwal, doesn't matter, which is known as al-mazdar al-qalbi, which we're going to speak about inshallah ta'ala in mutammimatul ajlumiyah, bi'idhnillah. And it is mansoob, like not wujuban, jawazan, permissible, it's not obligatory. Are you with me? Okay. And the author is going to now mention five conditions. Yeah, in his example. The five, he mentions them in his example. The first one is أن يكون مزدرًا. It has to be a verb or noun. The second one is أن يكون قلبيًا. And it also has to be qalbi. Qalbi here meaning something with your heart. It's your intention, right? Are you with me, brothers? Why did you hit this child, for example? ضربت ابني, I managed my child, تأديباً, mannering him. So he's talking about his heart, his intention, what his heart intended. It has to be that, or it's not أجلي. Number three is, أن يكون متحداً مع عامله في الوقت. It has to be united and with its agent in the timing. So when you are hitting him and your reasoning have to be both together. Fourth, أن يكون متحداً مع عامله في الفاعل. Again, the child who you're doing the hitting to and the عامل both have to be united as well. The fifth one is أن يكون علة لما قبله. It has to be reason for what has been done before. So in other words, why did you hit him? The answer has to be in the question. So تأديبا is a علة, reasoning of why you hit him. If these conditions are mentioned, if these five conditions are found, يجوز نصبه, it is permissible for you to make it منصوب. ويجوز جره, and you can also make it مجرور. Both are open for you, you are entitled for all. And it has three situations. It has the مفعول من أجله, it has three situations. أن يكون مقترنا بأل, that it is, can, it is brought with an أل. Are you with me? The second one is أن يكون مجردا من أل والإضافة. The second one is that it is stripped from B and Al entering it and an idafa. And the third one is for it to be a mudaf. Now, so those three I mentioned are going to be most expanded on the mutammima.
وهو الاسم المنصوب الذي يذكر لبيان من فعل معه الفعل نحو قولك جاء الأمير والجيش واستوى الماء والخشبة وأما خبر كان وفاتها واسم إن وفاتها فقد تقدم ذكرهما في المرفوعات وكذلك التوابع فقد تقدمت هنا.
The author now goes into المفعول معه. Al-maf'ulu ma'a. And he says, he gives three definitions that it has. First of all, it's an ism. And he said, al-mansub. So it's mansub. And then he says, al-ladhi yudhkaru li bayani man fu'ila ma'ahu al-fi'lu. And he clarifies the one man fu'ila ma'ahu al-fi'lu. It clarifies and explains to you man fu'ila, the one who it was done to him, with him, the action. جاء الشيخ والمراقب. For example, and it's also conditioned for it to come with after a waw. It's conditioned for it to come after a waw. For example, when you say جاء الشيخ, the شيخ came, والمراقب. So what are you doing here? You're doing the last part, which is you're clarifying this doing which the شيخ came with. Who's doing it with him? Okay, that's it. That's what it means. جاء الأمير, the أمير came. والجيش. That's مفعول معه. واستوى الماء والخشبة. This issue of عطف, when we spoke about it, and the difference between this one, we will leave it for what? The متممة, inshallah. Then the author, رحمه الله, after what he done was, he says that. So before I go to that, إِنَّ مَفْعُولُ مَعَهُ, the مَفْعُولُ مَعَهُ, sometimes it can be wajib al-nasb, that it's obligatory for you to make it mansub. For example, when it becomes, basically impossible, or it can't be, إِلَّمْ يَصِحْ عَطْفُهُ, if it's not correct to attach it to that which is before it, such as إِسْتَوَى الْمَاءُ وَالْخَشَبَةَ. The khashaba here is made mansub. Then if you make it other than mansub, you make it marfu', then the meaning becomes wrong. So you're in a situation where now you would have to make it mansub, so it's wajib al-nasbi. Are you with me? The opposite's gonna happen. If you say, "Istawa al-ma'u wal-khashabatu," what would come out of it? A meaning that is what? That the istiwa innama yakunu lishay' al-jari alladhi huwa al-ma'. If you say istawa al-ma'u, the water became, istiwa happened to the water above the khashaba. If you say khashabatu, you will say that the khashaba went on top of the water. Sah? Which is the opposite of what you're looking for. So here it becomes wajibun nasb. Okay? And sometimes it can be jaizun nasb. It can be jaiz, permissible. You can do it if you wish to. Like the qawl of the Shaykh, ja'a al-amir wal-jayshu. If you say that, that's not a problem. Okay? Ama wal-jaysha. You can say that. Both times is permissible. The meaning of what you're trying to say, nothing will happen. Then the author after that said, وَأَمَّا الْخَبَرُ كَانَ وَأَخَوَاتِهَا. We already spoke about that. وَإِنَّ وَأَخَوَاتِهَا. We already spoke about that. They're all mansoob. We spoke about them though. So they're all being spoken about. When we're talking about al-marfu'at. وَكَذَلِكَ التَّوَابِعُ. We spoke about the tawabi'. So these are the five that I mentioned to you already. We spoke about. Sahih brothers. So we're now going to go into بَابُ مَخْفُوضَاتِ الْأَسْمَاءِ. There are only three inshaAllah ta'ala. And that's the last part of today's session inshaAllah ta'ala. So we should be finished in the next half an hour.
باب المخفوضات الاسماء. المخفوضات ثلاثة أقسام. مخفوض بالحرف ومخفوض بالإضافة وتابع للمخفوض.
If anybody ever asks you, or if you ever see a noun that has خفض in it, till the day of judgment, you just need to remember is that it's only majrur or makhfud, either because half al huruf al jar went before it, or mudaf mudaf ilayh, or it's a tawabi', the four tawabi' that we mentioned. Badal, tawkid, atf, and na'at. One of those four, that's it. You will never ever find a noun that is makhfud other than those three. So you just need to know which of those three is. But Bab al-Mansubat is a bit tricky because it's 15, right? Huh? And what about Bab al-Marfu'at? It was what? 7. So a bit, sometimes it gets a bit tricky for you. And some of them emerge with one another with atf. Can you distinguish it between the badal and whatnot? But the khafd is the easiest one. So the first one is Harf bin Huruf al-Jar goes before it. We already took that. Farihtu bi Muhammadin. And the second one is, are you with me? Is Makhfud bin Idafa. قَدِمَ غُلَامُ مَحْمُودٍ. You with me, brothers? Mahmood here is مَخْفُوض with إِضَافَة. Is مَخْفُوض with إِضَافَة. And the third one is مَخْفُوض بِالتَّبَعِيَّةِ. It's مَخْفُوض because it's following it up, which is the four tawabi' that we took. The four tawabi' that we took. Now we're going to stand over each one. The author is going to bring it. Fadal.
أما المخفوض بالحرف فهو ما يخفض بمن وإلى وعن وعلى وفي ورب والباء والكاف واللام وحروف القسم وهي الواو والباء والتاء وبواو رب وبمذ وبمنذ
وبمذ
وبمذ وبمنذ وبمذ ومنذ.
The author رحمه الله, here he speaks about the first type of the makhfudat of asma. What you need to remember, the huruf al-jarri are three types. We're just going to mention the types here. We're going to leave it open, and inshallah ta'ala mutammima, we'll finish that stuff for us inshallah ta'ala. The first one is called harf al-jar asli. The huruf al-jar are usul, their foundations. The second one is called harf al-jar, which is shabih bi-zaida. It is called harf al-jar, which is شبيه بالزائد. And the third one is حرف جر, which is زائد. Okay? Those three are the types of حروف الجر there are. And we're going to touch on that more in our شرح متممة الأجرونية. The author رحمه الله here, he mentions أدوات that are many that the حروف الجر come with. The first one is من, And min ma'nahu, the meaning that he has is what? Ibtida, starting from somewhere. Wa minka wa min nuhin, from you and nuh. Okay? That's where it starts from. Ila, it means to the end, somewhere. It's where, when you finally reach. So what you brothers need to know is that the word min, does it place jar on apparent nouns? Yes. Does it place jar on pronouns, dhamair? Yes. So min does both. Yo, are you with me, brothers? Both of them, it makes jar on it. Okay. Ila is the same. It does it for dhahir and mudmar. An, it does it for dhahir and mudmar, and it means mujawaza. Mujawaza means when you pass something, through something. Allah says in the Quran, radiyallahu anhum. So you can see it enters pronouns. And it also enters ism dhahir, which is what? Are you with me, brothers? So I showed you minka is pronoun. Minka. Wa min nuhin and nuh alayhi salam. Ism dhahir entered into it, and it entered into ism dhamir. Are you with me, brothers? The same is with what you call it, ila. You can say, ilallahi marji'ukum. Or you can say to, wa ilayhi turja'un. Ilayhi is a pronoun, right? An is also the same. It can enter into a dhahir and a mudmar. Qawluhu ta'ala, radiyallahu an hum 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 is a pronoun. And you can say, laqad radiyallahu anil mu'minin. Al mu'minin is ism dhahir. Ala is the same. It does it to ism dhahir and ism mudmar. Okay? Such as qawluhu ta'ala, وعليها وعلى الفلك تحملون وعليها is a ها is a pronoun وعلى الفلك الفلك is ism ظاهر في is also the same وفي السماء رزقكم في السماء سماء is ism ظاهر and also قوله تعالى وفيها ما تشتهيه الأنفس صح so وفيها is a pronoun. It does it the same. Rubba on the other hand, lakin, it shows, are you with me brothers? Ism dhahir only. Rubba rajulin. You cannot say rubbak or rubbaku. You can't. It only enters into ism which is dhahir. The ba here, it enters ism dhahir and ism which is mudmar, both. So you can the ba. So you can say, اعتصمتُ بالله or you can say اعتصمتُ به no problem the kaf only ism ظاهر you won't accept ism مضمر محمد كالأسد okay كالأسد the lam it enters ism ظاهر and ism مضمر and it has three meanings when it comes حروف الجر the lam it comes as للملك ownership اختصاص specification استحقاق deserving it comes in those three meanings as a حرف من حروف الجر okay but what is the difference between the three the difference between it is الملك means الواقعة بين الذات أحدهما it basically falls between two essence one of the two so you say المال للأمير وله الدار okay وله الدار اختصاص on the other hand, it falls between what? بين الذاتين, two essences, لملك and ownership of one. الباب للدار. نعم. وله مفتاح. The third one is استحقاق. استحقاق falls between two thats and two meanings. Which is like, for example, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. It's istihqaq. Others have differed. The tenth one that the author mentioned is the waw. And it's used for an oath when you're making a promise. Wallahi. And it's only used for ism which is zahir. Duha. Wadduha. We said the ba is used for ism zahir and mudmar. For example, you can say uqsimu billahi and you can say uqsimu bihi. Correct. The ta, on the other hand, it is used for ism zahir, which is Allah's name alone, which is lafzul jalala. You cannot use it for any other ism zahir. Then the author, rahimahullah, he wrote wawawi rubba, and the waw of rubba. The waw or rubba, the rubba is going to be mahdufa. The only waw is going to remain, like the qawl of Umar Uqays, walaylin kamawjil bahri arkha sudulahu alayya bi anwa'il humumi liyabtali. Naam. Walaylin ay wa rubba laylin. That's what it's meant to be. So the waw here is the waw of rubba. But the rubba fell. So when you explain it, you say, walaylin. كموج البحر أرخى سدوله علي بأنواع الهموم ليبتلي. Number 14 and 15 is مذ and مذ, and they both mean the same. نعم, تكلم.
وأما ما يحفظ بالإضافة فنحو قولك غلام زيد وهو على قسمين, ما يقدر باللام وما يقدر بمن؟
بمن.
فالذي يقدر باللام نح غلام زيد, والذي يقدر بمن نح ثوب خز وباب ساج وخاتم حديد.
The author now goes into the second type of مخفوضات الأسماء, right? And he mentions عليه رحمة الله the author, rahimahullah, he mentions the second type and he categorized it into two. He categorized it into two. ما يقدر باللام وما يقدر بمن. The first one he said is ما يقدر. بمن. Let's start with من. What does it mean? What does من show you? From, right? So what it means is that the مضاف is part of the مضاف إليه. It's a part of it. The في is also mentioned. There's another third one which is, there's another one which is في, which is in. And it's basically أن يكون المضاف إليه ظرفا للمضاف. It's in it. As Allah said in the Quran, مكر الليل في الليل, in the night. In the night. And the third one is مقدر here right now is لام, which is غلام زيد, أي غلام لزيد. غلام لزيد. Those are the types. So the one that's min is all that which the author mentions here, which is khadimun, khatamu sawi hadidin, min hadidin, thawbu khazin, okay? That's all, babu sajin, all of that is min from it. The lam is ghulamu zaydin. And he didn't mention the third one, which is the fee. Yeah. As for the tabaiyya, which is the badal, the tawkeed, all of that, we already covered that. So we already taken that al-makhfudu bi-tabaiyya. So the author didn't even bring it basalatan. He doesn't mention it, and he doesn't talk about it because we already took it. And هذا ما أردت إبرازه. That's what we intended to bring out to you all to know. And اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا ولا تجعل في ما علمتنا وبالا علينا. And inshallah ta'ala, tomorrow we're going to be doing the explanation of the kitab آداب البحث والمناظرة, written by Tash Kubri Asamuddin Abu Khair. Basically talks about debating and researching and So it's a small book, very simple, easy. Inshallah ta'ala, we'll go through that as well, bi-idhnillahi, tomorrow. It's a very practical book, so it's something that a lot of you just relate to, because Allah said in the Quran, وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ أَكْثَرَ شَيْءٍ. We're all debaters. It's in us. It's in our nature. So I'm just going to teach you how to debate proper. So this is it, inshallah ta'ala. Subhanakallah wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayhi.